Beyond that was the room with rewind benches and the single file slots for each film reel. There was a row of perhaps 20 such film slots. This was also the storage area for the cans of 35mm films brought in by Leo from the back of his Renault van after he had collected them from the film distributors. That was my world, and I loved the sense of comfort and isolation it gave me. It was my new monk-like existence. The cinema opened most days at 5:30 p.m., but there were matinees Wednesday, Saturday and Sunday. The turnover of films was huge. A double feature Monday to Wednesday, two new ones Thursday to Saturday, with shorts like The Three Stooges and typically a Western for the Saturday matinee, and another film just for Sunday night. What this meant, of course, was that a lot of old films were being recycled. Even then, in the latter half of the 60s, TV had not taken over from cinema, and the tradition of going to the pictures was strong. At the end of the show, and this was typical of all cinemas as much as it was at the end of Ireland's TV transmission, the national anthem played, and all who had not scarpered during the end credits of the film stood solemnly for it. In the projection booth, we had a 45 RPM record that had a full version of the anthem, then a small visible gap on the record, then a merciful short version. We had the latter queued up to start playing when the house lights were up and the curtain closed. While this vast turnover of films, and the amount of work to be done in the course of feeding the changing reels and all that involved, meant I only saw scraps of films, I would later consider that to be a mercy. In my time at the Kenilworth, there were only two films that ran for a full week on their own in all the screening slots. These were The Sand Pebbles and Planet of the Apes. In each case, Harry and Leo and I were going nuts and could almost say all the lines. Steve McQueen's last line in Sand Pebbles became a running gag for us. What the hell happened?